Many thanks to Nov, Jerb, Skillspeeder Gaming, Devotan, and Jaren for making this video possible. As of 1.10, DayZ has become a lot colder. We're faced with two choices now. Bend over and let this blue bastard boldly bite away at our sweet apple, or adapt to the huge list of changes and become HIV positive, which of course stands for heat insulation value. Being HIV positive in DayZ means this icon is happy and shows an up arrow, but with the changes to how items now cool down in clothing, a rebalance to how hot gear makes you, and the addition of the new heat buffer stat, finding HIV heaven has become that much more difficult. To find it again, I've consolidated all the stuff that makes you HIV happy into four categories, starting with the most powerful, yet most time consuming, fireplaces. First of all, no factor impacts the probability that a fire will light or not, but there are a set of parameters that restricts you from lighting one. The first one checks if you are in a building, and the second one checks the moisture level of the fireplace. So if you're in a building, you cannot light a fireplace on the floor, or if it's damp, you cannot either. However, you can light one under several different canopies, so it's not a proximity of the roof. There's some sort of box that goes around these buildings that stops you from lighting fireplaces. What you use to light a fireplace doesn't matter either, but matches are the best, as you can light a maximum of 100 fireplaces compared to the lighter with a maximum of 50 fireplaces when full. The type of fireplace you light is also irrelevant. They all warm you up and warm up at the same rate. In addition, they all consume fuel at the same rates too. Every fireplace in DayZ has a 2-meter radius around it that penetrates all surfaces, which means you can get the benefits of a fireplace while remaining dry inside of a tent or even through a wall or a door, as long as you're within 2 meters of the fireplace. However, the closer you get to that fireplace, the more HIV positive you become, with almost being on top of the fireplace being the most beneficial. Be careful though, because if you step on a fire, you will take 3 health damage per second and it will damage your gear rapidly, so it's not worth it. Creating multiple fireplaces doesn't increase the radius of a fireplace, nor does it warm you up faster, and items you heat up in fireplaces now cool down over time. All items you warm up in fireplaces still increase your HIV when placed in your inventory, but the only items you can warm up are items that can be used for cooking, such as food, the cooking pot, or the frying pan. Putting stones, for example, in this part will only ruin the stones, not warm them up. All of these decrease in temperature at 0.25 Celsius per second when on a player, but 0.5 Celsius per second when anywhere else in the world, meaning food stays warmer when it's inside your inventory. Now, because everything cools down at the same rate when it's in the same location, the maximum you heat an item up to is how long it will stay warm in your inventory or on the floor. So for foods such as fruits, vegetables, mushrooms, meats and fat which can be placed in a fireplace, that's 100 Celsius at a maximum, or 6 minutes inside a player inventory, 3 minutes on the floor. And for the cooking pot and the frying pan, because they can be heated up to 200 Celsius, that's 12 minutes or 6 minutes on the floor. Therefore, cooking food and then storing that food in your inventory for 6 minutes before eating it is a great way to extend the huge amount of benefits that fireplaces provide. Another great benefit to fireplaces is the newly added heat buffer stat, which I'm sure you guys are interested in knowing about, which is only gained from sitting near fireplaces. Again, the type of fireplace you use to get this buff makes no difference at all. When using an internal fireplace, such as inside a house, it takes around 45 seconds to get this heat buffer stat. When outside, it can take up to 3 minutes to get this stat while remaining white or normal temperature near the fireplace. However, if you're cold, you will never get the heat buffer stat. The heat buffer is displayed with this plus symbol and provides a significant fixed amount of HIV positivity for a minimum of 3 minutes. After this 3 minutes has expired, your heat buffer stat will decrease at the rate that corresponds with your current HIV. From my tests, while under the coldest conditions, I lost a heat buffer stat in 4 minutes, and while wearing some of the best HIV gear in the game, I lost it in a little under 8 minutes. While you have this heat buffer symbol, it's almost impossible to become cold, even in water, so getting this buff before swimming across a river or to an island can help you to not lose health through hypothermia. That's almost guaranteed with going in water now. Again, the only way to get this buffer is to sit within 2 meters of a fireplace. You can't gain it by stuffing your clothes full of hot items like heat packs. Speaking of which, the size of heat packs has been reduced to only 2 slots and now lasts for 20 minutes once activated. It doesn't warm you up as much as a piece of meat does, but lasts much longer. Heat packs are pretty rare, but you can DIY a heat pack using burnt meat. Simply heat up the meat and enjoy 6 minutes of heat. And yes, heat benefits from several items do stack at once. What won't warm you up, however, is a flare or a crafted torch. Moving on to being inside, it removes the effects of wind chill, fog and even altitude from the HIV calculation, making you much, much warmer. The inside of houses and other buildings provide these benefits, but bus stops and canopies in general don't. They only provide shelter from the rain. To identify when you're receiving these benefits, you should notice a huge change in your temperature stat immediately, the rain sound effects becoming quieter, and the ability to light fireplaces is non-existent. So like I was talking about earlier, buildings have this invisible heat hitbox on them. Once you enter the hitbox, you get the HIV benefits of not being affected by wind chill, fog or altitude, but you can't light fireplaces, which means being near windows or doors won't make you colder. The transition from being inside to being outside this hitbox is instant. Being inside a tent provides the same benefits as being inside a house, and as fireplace warmth penetrates surfaces, you can put a fireplace outside your tent and become the most HIV positive person on the server. Just be aware that fireplaces can be seen up to the maximum render distance, which is around 1000 meters. And finally, we come to insulation level, which is a combined insulation level that your clothes provide you, which is without question the most complex aspect of staying warm. Every clothing item in DayZ has two stats on it that impact your temperature, the heat insulation value of an item and the maximum moisture level of an item. Heat insulation value, or again HIV, is between 100% and 0% on a piece of clothing. Every 20% it increases, you will see it gain a level in game, with bad being between 0 and 20, going to low, medium, high and finally best. This percentage is affected by the moisture and quality level of the piece of clothing. For example, if this mountain backpack is soaked, it is now medium insulation due to it losing 50%, as seen here. If it becomes badly damaged too, it knocks 50% off of 50%, leaving it with 25%, or as seen here, low insulation. So when it comes to maximizing HIV from clothing, all you need to do really is select the best pieces of gear to make you warm, keep it dry, and keep it repaired. The best gear would depend on how you play. If you hide from the rain, then the maximum moisture level of an item impacts you less than someone that doesn't care and runs in the rain, just like me. Now, I believe that most people are like me and they just run in the rain and they don't really care, so we're going to focus on gear that gives you a lot of HIV while also providing a low maximum moisture level so you can dance in the rain if you want to. The clothing that impacts your HIV in DayZ are these 8, so everything but your weapons, belt, glasses and armband protects you from the cold. These 8 all have multipliers on them which impacts the HIV of your clothing. For example, the backpack slot provides only 45% of its HIV value, where the vest provides 64%, which means that the chest slot and the pants provide the biggest benefit to HIV at 100%. The three best helmets to fight the cold are the Gorkha or Assault Helmet, the Firefighter Helmet, or any of the Motorcycle Helmets. This indicates the maximum moisture value, and this indicates the HIV of the item. For the mask slot, any of the gas masks are great due to their low moisture levels, but the balaclavas in the game are good too if you don't get them wet. If they do become wet, they can get up to drenched, reducing their HIV to zero. This is why they're not on my list here, which is the same as not wearing anything at all if you're not aware. The jacket or t-shirt you wear is very important in the game. Here are the best three in the game: the Firefighter Jacket, Hunter Top, or M65 Jacket. For vests, the plate carrier, press vest, or tactical vest are the best. For backpacks, we have the newly added leather sack, hunting bag, and mountain backpack. Gloves are the combat gloves, work gloves, or tactical gloves. Pants, another very important slot, firefighter pants, hunter pants, or the Gorkha or patrol pants. And finally, we have shoes at 0.5 as a multiplier, with combat boots, assault boots, and hiking boots being the best. But any type of boots are going to be really good at fighting the cold. If I had to choose one piece from each of these 8 slots, it would be these. The reason I haven't gone with the firefighter gear is because it's very, very heavy compared to the hunter gear. This gear alone is very strong at fighting back the cold. You're even able to swim without going hypothermic and get out of water without needing a new pair of balls. If you want to go above and beyond this, you can aim to keep this gear dry by using a fireplace and putting your gear in front of it. All clothing dries at the same speed, it only depends on which method you use. So putting your clothes within 2 meters of a fireplace on the floor will dry them in 45 seconds from fully drenched. Alternatively, it will take 2.5 minutes if you stand with the clothes on within 2 meters of a fireplace. Putting your clothes on the floor without a fireplace will take roughly 30 minutes to dry them, depending on how sunny and how windy that server is. But if you leave them on without a fireplace, it would take roughly 2 hours while stood still, or while sprinting, 1 hour and 40 minutes to go from drenched to dry while wearing the piece of clothing. So using a fireplace is very beneficial for keeping your clothes dry. However, wringing your clothes is the most overpowered method, as it requires no tools and very little time. For each completed cycle here, a piece of clothing loses one stage of moisture and can be wrung until damp. Now, damp only removes 10%, as we talked about earlier, from clothing's HIV value and would dry out in 25 minutes from sprinting, something that's worthwhile. The drawback is only half of your beneficial clothing slots can be wrung, and only cloth masks and cloth hats can be wrung. So if wringing these isn't enough to get you back to normal temperature again, you will need a fireplace to dry your clothes. The alternative, if you want to keep this blue, is to consume one apple every 1 minute and 40 seconds. That's how much energy you lose while that's blue. If the reason you got wet in the first place is because you went for a swim, you can store your clothing inside any backpack that cannot become soaked or drenched, such as a dry bag, hunting bag, or even a leather sack. Only clothing items that become soaked or drenched will allow items inside them to gain moisture, which also means that ammo boxes, protector cases and other containers will stop your items from collecting water. Just be aware that the cooking pot with water inside will make any items you put inside damp. The final point I want to cover in this video is sprinting. Is it worth doing? Because sprinting warms you up. You're essentially consuming energy from sprinting to not consume energy from this being blue. The answer, if sprinting makes you normal temperature again, then do it. If not, then... For the remaining four factors that change your HIV in a negative way, check out my previous video where I go over all the things that make you cold, including how the temperature stat actually works. A lot of useful info there to help you in this cold patch and to help you survive the mask when it's released. However, if you've watched both videos and still have questions, please do post them below. I answer all questions I can. Thank you for watching and have a good day.